I love how they don't use their indicator. Look at that. No indication. No indication. No indication. Oh my god. Hello everyone. Today I am doing a little vlog on my little shopping trip today. So, one thing I know I need to pick up is a new watch strap. I've been looking for the chain link one, whatever it's called. It's the metal, like, chain link one. This one here, it's the nylon weave, I think that it's called, and it makes my skin itch, so I'm getting a new strap. That, the bare flooring van that you just saw go past, oh, hang on, you wouldn't have seen it. Does that guy even know indicators exist? I'm not a huge fan of doing vlogs while I'm driving because my road rage is, yeah, it's pretty up there. But I think it's justified. I mean, I've just spent like 15 minutes traveling alongside this moron who I don't think even knows indicators exist. You know, he's probably thinking in his head, fuck, I wish there was some way of me indicating to people that I'm fucking crossing the lane or turning off or whatever I'm doing. I don't think he knows they already exist. Alright, we're going to the Coomera Westfields. So, yeah, this is down where all like the theme parks and shit are. Recently bought a Movie World year pass, so I might start doing some vlogs there. Oh, we got a Taco Bell going in here. Hopefully that's better than the one near my area, because the one near my area kind of sucks. Okay, I have entered at 10:03 a.m. How much do they get you for? You get 2.5 hours free parking, do you? No, up to 2 hours. I pride myself in my parallel parking. Like, it's a bit of a flex for me. I like to get it like square in the lines, equal space on each side. So let's see how I did. Well, that was a big bust. They did not have what I was looking for. Those are particular bands that I'm after. They seem to be really popular. So, off to the next place. I swear to God, I saw them, like, because I checked at work, because you can see the stock other stores have. And I swear to God, I saw that Coomera had one of them. But that's the thing when a store's showing one, is quite often, they don't actually have any. Whether it's due to a stock error or a theft, you know, they just don't have it. So it's a bit hit and miss. The last stop on our journey is actually going to be Pacific Fair, because I want to go to Culture Kings, bruh. And that's where they are. Alright, we're going past Dreamworld's entrance. That's a place I've never been to, but I want to go. I almost went to Dreamworld when I was like 15. For free. But it was with this like boys' youth club thing that I was in, like, because I was a troubled kid. And I went to that school and they were going to take us to Dreamworld as a, like, excursion. But the day we were meant to go to Dreamworld, during the night, someone smashed up the bus so we couldn't go. That is real.
Get out of the way, Toby. Get on the right side of the road, you pelican.
So I'm now on the Gold Coast, just up the Pacific Fair. Check out these buildings here. It's been a while since I was here. Way over there, that's where I used to live. JB, I went to finally found what I was looking for. All right, so I've just left the shopping center. I can't film in there a lot because my anxiety kind of peaks because people always look at me and it's like, are they looking at me because they think I'm a hottie or they can clock me or they think I'm a weirdo, whatever. So filming myself, it's just gonna make it like worse. So yeah, I'll do as best I can, but it's hard. But anyway, I left JB and I got what I came for, which is this. This is the metal one. So it's the rose gold metal. So it's harder to get than I thought it would be, but I finally got one and I'm going to put it on that. Tell you what, they like to protect it. Look at that. There's plastic all over it. All right, it took a while, but I got there. Look at that, that looks so much better. Now that I've got that, let's head back home and do some clothes shopping at my favorite store, Cotton On. Good morning, everyone. Well, it's morning here anyway. I'm heading to a few charity stores and I'm gonna go try on some clothes. And I get people ask me to make these videos and I've made them in the past, just never liked how they turned out. So I've never bothered editing or uploading or anything like that. But I figured I will give it the good old college try today. And yeah, I'm heading out anyway, so I might as well try and make some videos out of it. Show you guys where I go, the sorts of things I look at, and what my fashion sense is like. I used to sort of not care, but now I actually try and make an effort to look nice. So I like to think I'm fine tuning my look. So yeah. So the first one I'm going to, there was actually another one that I wanted to go to, but the parking lot was full. So I was just like, yeah, nah, I'm not that desperate. So yeah, I'm going to a smaller one. Still has a decent size movie collection though. So yeah. I'm just heading past a shopping center here. So that shopping center there's the pawn shop in there. And for some reason, this pawn shop sells movies, like just a DVD, like an old DVD for like $6. It's like, dude, like just about any pawn shop would be lucky if they're charging $2 for that. But this one over here, about $6. You don't want to know how much the Blu-rays are. This one is another full parking lot. What the fuck's going on? Why is everything so full? I have never been down this end. I didn't even know there was a cafe there. Like literally, there's actually a cafe right there. I've been here so many times, and that's the first time I've realized there is actually a cafe there. We are off. I bought a few things there, a couple of movies and a nice vest that I'm gonna sort of spice up a little bit. So I'm heading to that shopping center I showed you or pointed out earlier. You didn't really see it. Because I need to go to the loo and that's the closest public toilets I can think of. So that's where I'm heading. Alrighty, let's go in.
This is the creepy corridor to head down to the ladies' toilets.
I am back in the car with the AC on because it is a scorcher out there. I'm sorry I don't film much when I'm inside. I get stared at a lot and it makes me really self-conscious, and I don't really want to make it worse by pulling the camera out and filming a lot. So I got hungry, so I've got a pork sausage and a lasagna topper because I'm hungry. But I wanted to show you what I got from the charity store first at that last place. First thing I got is this really nice vest. It is really nice. It's only $6. It's a really slim fitting one because it's a boy's size 14. I don't know if it's a boy's. I know it's a size 14, but I don't know. I'm assuming it's for boys if it's a size 14. But yeah, it is really nice and it's really fitting, which is what I like. So with this one, I'm going to try and spruce it up a bit, maybe get some different colored buttons for it, like, I don't know, pink or purple, and then put some patches on it. Make it look really like punk. So yeah, that's my plans for that vest. I also got some DVDs. The first one is Snoop Dogg's Hood of Horrors. So this is apparently three different tales of horror, I guess. So one of them is, I'll just read you the back of it because it's kind of intriguing. The Hound of Hell, Snoop Dogg, is your guide through three terrifying tales from this nefarious neighborhood and its depraved denizens? D-E-N-I-Z-E-N-S, however you pronounce that. The tales include a tagger who finds out that not all gangsters die hard, a spoiled heir to a Texas oil dynasty who murders for money but can't pay to stay alive, and a major rap star that discovers a few skeletons in his dressing room and they're kicking the door down. So that's what that's about. Second one I got is the jacket. Yeah, I don't know. There's the Subnosis on the back of it there. So yeah. That just looked intriguing, so I got it. Next one is Night of the Living Dead. I've heard this is kind of a good movie. I don't know whether it was the specific one, but I'm pretty sure it is because it's the old one. So yeah, that one's going to be interesting to watch. And finally, I got U-Boat War. This is a documentary, I'm pretty sure, and I love documentaries, so I picked that one up. So yeah, that's what I got. Yeah, so I'm going to have a little bite to eat and then head on to the next charity store. One thing that does, like, impress me about that place is it's, like, one of the only places left that has those. They call it an internet cafe, but it's just a bunch of computers in the middle of a shopping center. But you can access the internet on it, and I still think it's amazing in the year 2023 that they still have that sitting there, because there's not many of them left.
Okay, next we have One World Charity Store.
Alright guys, this was just a short video, I guess. I'm gonna leave this one here. This was just a short vlog. Hopefully you enjoyed it. I'll try and make longer ones in the future when I'm actually doing like a proper shop around at different charity stores, try and make a kind of a day of it, I guess. But yeah, I'm gonna leave this video here. Hopefully you enjoyed it. Until next time, ciao for now.